The authors do not have any financial interests to disclose.
White intumescent cataracts are a very common problem in a country like India. The main problem associated with this white intumescent cataracts is a very high intralenticular pressure, which makes the rexus very, very difficult. Argentina flag sign, wherein the rexus gives way in two directions, is not uncommon in white intumescent cataracts. This Argentina flag sign can be prevented to a large extent by certain maneuvers which I am going to show in this video. What is the problem with this Argentina flag sign? The problem with this Argentina flag sign is that the rexus, because of the extension, can extend across the equator and go to the posterior capsule, thereby producing a posterior capsule rupture or even a nucleus drop, as you can see in this particular video. Once the Argentina flag sign occurs, you can complete the phaco by doing a semicircular rexus on either side, a direct chop technique, or the karate chop is being employed in this particular case. The cataract is emulsified in the iris plane or to a certain extent in the anterior chamber. The endothelium is protected by means of a good viscoelastic like viscote, which is now and then inflated into the anterior chamber. In this particular case, an Argentina flag sign has been converted into a semicircular rexus on either side with the successful implantation of the intraocular lens into the bag. And the patient did very well with a vision of 6/6 N6 postoperatively. To prevent this Argentina flag sign, I developed a technique called the punctor rexus. What is this punctor rexus? A straight tip, either a 15 degree or a 0 degree, with the bevel down, is directed towards the center of the anterior capsule, and a sudden burst of phaco emulsification. The phaco power is approximately 40%. The vacuum of around 350 to 400 millimeters of mercury is given. And because of the sudden burst of the phaco emulsification, there is a sudden decompression of the bag and the Argentina flag sign does not occur. In this video, you can see here again, I am using a straight tip 15 degree, bevel down, going into the center of the capsule and then giving a punch. This technique is called punctor rexus. Once you make a punch in the anterior capsule, what happens is there is a sudden decompression. And because of that, there is no tendency of the capsule to extend to the periphery, thereby preventing an Argentina flag sign. In this case, you can see here, after the punch, I use regular viscoelastic like HPMC. And then complete the rexus with the Utrata forceps. If you notice very carefully, in the punctor rexus, again I am going bevel down, and in one stroke I am doing a punch of the anterior capsule. Same time I am giving a burst of phaco emulsification. Thereby there is a slight debulking of the center of the nucleus. And because of this debulking of the nucleus, and the sudden decompression of the interlenticular pressure, there is no time for the rexus or the capsule to extend to the periphery, thereby preventing an Argentina flag sign. Again, if you notice the center of this particular nucleus, there is a small debulking area which has been caused by the sudden phaco burst, and this actually has helped in reducing the interlenticular pressure, and the rexus is round and you can complete the rexus in the usual way with the Utrata forceps or with the needle, whichever you are comfortable with. The puncture rexus can be followed by a technique called the phaco rexus. In this phaco rexus, what we do is we use the phaco needle itself, as you can see here, bevel down, and do the rexus by aspirating the capsular flap and using a bimanual technique like a Sinsky hook or a rod through the side port, which is on the left side. And they can see here how I am aspirating the capsule slowly and steadily, but with lot of control. And this condition or this technique is called the phaco rexus technique, wherein after the punch with the phaco burst, which I mentioned earlier, you can go ahead and do the phaco rexus with great control, thereby preventing this Argentina flag sign from going to the periphery. In this video, you can see a puncture rexus followed by a phaco rexus. The take-home message is, in white intermittent cataracts, to prevent an Argentina flag sign, puncture rexus can be done very effectively, or puncture rexus followed by phaco rexus can be done very successfully in completing the rexus 200% of the time in white intermittent cataracts.